Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how I did this extremely cute protective style. I put on one of my newer dresses today as I was heading to a food festival with my family, and it was just screaming Bridgerton, which is a show I absolutely love. So I wanted to do a hairstyle along with it that made me feel like a lady. So this style is so great for the warm weather as it keeps your hair off of your shoulders. The ends of your hair are completely tucked away as well, so no damage at all. Plus, I use a technique that ensures that there is no tension on your hairline at all, so make sure you watch the entire video in order to understand that completely. You can also keep your hair in this style for multiple days, and the best part is that this is something that you can totally do before work, as it only took me about 10 minutes. So to do this hairstyle, all you need is one ponytail holder, a few bobby pins, and a brush. That's it. I personally don't use gels, but if you want, you can use that as well. So this is me after getting dressed and doing some light makeup. I slept with my hair in a scarf last night. If you watched my last video, you may be wondering why it's not a bonnet. The scarf is actually more common for me, especially when I want my hair to be flat the next day, as it doesn't rub against my hair at night like a bonnet does. Scarves stay in place and I can be a very wiggly sleeper. My last wash day was 13 days ago, so this braid out is very old, and as you can see, I set my hair in one braid last night. If you'd like to know how I maintain my braid outs over time, please check out my latest video as I detail my braid out bedtime routine there. So first things first, I'm taking down the braid. Once I remove my flexi rod, I coat my ends with some argan oil before slowly unraveling it. The next step would be to make a parting in the middle of your hair going ear to ear. It doesn't have to be neat because it shouldn't be visible at the end. I have some forever parts, so I'm using those today. Then I'm just going to clip the front portion away for the time being and work on the back section first. What we want to do is braid into one large braid. The important thing here is to make sure that we braid it as loosely as possible. This is because we want the braid to be voluminous and take up as much space as possible later on. Once the braid is done, we want to then pull the braid apart more to make it even wider. This is the result. Now we'll move on to the front portion. So this is where the no tension technique begins. I don't know about you, but I have a very sensitive hairline, and I also get headaches whenever my hair is pulled in any way. So I like to do whatever I can to minimize tension. The first step to doing this is securing the ponytail in the least damaging way possible. To do this, I don't put my ponytail holders on over my hair in a traditional fashion. When I do that, I always end up pulling as my hair gets tangled all around the holder and breaking my hair as a result of that as well. I made a short on how I secure my ponytails in the least damaging way possible, and I will link it in the description below. All you need for that is a ponytail holder and a bobby pin, and what you can see on the screen at the moment is a visual representation of this. If you do want a closer look, again, you can find the link to the video in the description box below. Along with tying my ponytail holder in a specific way to avoid breakage, I'm also tying the ponytail itself very loosely. This is the second way in which I am avoiding breakage. We don't want the ponytails to be pulling at our hairlines all day. This does lead to a bulkier look that you can currently see, but don't worry, I'll show you how to solve that a little bit later on. Now I'm just going to, again, loosely braid this portion and pull it apart gently at the end to make the braid wider. This is what it should look like once you're done. Now we just want to again clip the top section away, as we're going to work on the back section first. Then we're going to flatten the braid to our head and wrap it around itself in a spiral until there's none left. And then we want to tuck the ends underneath to protect them completely. When you're doing this, it's important to make sure that the braid is as flat to your head as possible. This ensures that the hairstyle looks more full and just looks, and the pattern just looks more beautiful that way. Then just clip the spiral into place with a few bobby pins in different areas. Please remember to use the bobby pins gently as well. If you feel any tension, please be reposition them and try not to poke straight through to the scalp. Angle them horizontally rather than through your hair to do this. Then we're going to do exactly the same thing with the front as well, and you should be left with something like this. Now, as you can see, the front is quite loose and bulky. It's cute, but I think it's a little bit too much for my head shape. So now we're going to employ my third technique that helps me reduce tension as well as get the desired aesthetic outcome that I'm looking for without pulling at my hairline. The secret is more bobby pins. I use them again to loosely pin my hair down into its desired shape without any pulling. Just as when we applied them to the buns, we're making sure to apply them horizontally as close to the hair surface as possible as to not create any type of pulling or breakage at the root. We are also making sure that they are slightly further back in the style, so they're not too visible from the front. This gives the illusion that the hair is just secured by the ponytail holder and nothing else. One other tip that I haven't mentioned is that I'm also using matte bobby pins. This is something so subtle, but I've realized that they blend in with my hair so much more seamlessly than the shiny ones and therefore tend to look more natural. I found these ones at Boots. If you're in the UK, you probably know what that is. If not, I'm sure you can find them at your local beauty supply store. Finally, I'm just twisting up my little sideburns just to add to the style a little bit. I'm not a gel user for several reasons, so this is one of the ways that I choose to add character to my style and make the front look quote unquote a little bit more neat. If you would like more information about why I don't use gel, you can find that in another video that I did a few months ago, and I'll link this in the description box as well. So that's it for the hairstyle itself. I hope you love the look. I wish I had some flowers to go with it as well. I think that would be super cute. To finally put the whole look together, I'm just changing my earrings to some teardrop shaped pearls, as well as powdering my face a little more because it's gotten super shiny sitting on my lights. Then a few sprays of my current perfume scent, and I'm finally done. Here is what I look like overall with the dress on. I didn't realize how the camera was positioned, so I just had to kneel a little bit so you could see. And that is all for the video today. I really hope you enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments what you think and if you would try this hairstyle or if you've done something like this before. Let me know if you like these short protective styling tutorials as well and if you want me to do some more, because I have a ton of hairstyles that we can try. I do read all of your comments and even reply to most of them as well. One thing to mention before I go is that I actually have a secret video. This is something that I talked about a few videos back, and if you haven't had a chance to sign up and have a look, please do. The video itself is totally free, in which I talk about 5 reasons why your natural hair isn't growing. And in that video, I do detail a lot of different things that are not talked about a lot, I think, in the natural hair community. And I guess some of them could be the key to more length retention for yourself as well. So if you are interested in watching the secret video, please click the link in the bio. But yeah, that is all from me today. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!